Hey, hello friends, welcome to my channel. Now see about V8 engine. V8 engines are basically have the 8 cylinder with V configuration that's are mounted on the single crankcase, and obviously 8 cylinder is used in common crankshaft. Most of the V8 engines angles are in 90 degree are used, sometimes 45, 60 and 72 angles may be used. It's just like the inline 4 cylinder engine, but it has two I-4 engines are combined like that. The angle between two these inline engines are 90, 45, 60 and 72. There is some dynamic imbalance in I-4 engine to eliminate this type of problem V8 engines are introduced. The dynamic imbalance is managed by the crankshaft counterweight. Crankshaft design of V8 engine is awesome than the V6 engine. These V8 engines are best in counterweight to opposite force from the piston. Because of counterweight, the vibration and torque transmission is controlled, but this design is less expensive than V12 engines. The most prevalent V angle for a V8 is 90 degrees. This configuration features a wide-low engine with optimal firing and vibration characteristics. Many V6 and V10 engine configurations are derived from production V8 designs, so they often use the 90 degrees angle. However, balance shafts are incorporated to reduce vibration and slash or more complex cranks to even the firing cycle. One example is the Ford / Yamaha V8 used in the Ford Tourist Show. It was based on Ford's Duratec V6 and shares that engine's 60 degrees V angle. A similar Yamaha-built engine was used by Volvo cars between 2005 and 2010. These engines were designed for transverse front-wheel drive installation and are narrower than usual for efficient use of space. Because they are not at the ideal 90 degrees angle for a V8, they require a counter-rotating balance shaft and offset split crank pins for complete smoothness. Additionally, 72 degrees V8 engines have been used in modern racing. An extremely narrow angle V8 was introduced by Lancia in 1922, which had an angle between cylinder banks of only 14 degrees. This created an engine that was shorter than a straight 6 but much narrower than a conventional V8. It was based on a Lancia V4 engine design that was almost completely square in the length and width of its layout. Because of their compact design and overhead camshafts, these engines were lighter and more powerful than comparable engines of the time. Although Lancia stopped making the V8 design around World War II, the basic concept is used today in the Volkswagen VR6 engine. Thank you, bye, see in next video, don't forget to subscribe.